हेलो, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल गेन जावा नॉलेज। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट कोरिलेशन आईडी इन स्प्रिंग बूट 3.2.1 वर्जन एंड व्हाई वी नीड टू इम्प्लीमेंट कोरिलेशन आईडी एंड व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ यूजिंग दिस कोरिलेशन आईडी। सो वी गो वन बाय वन। सो फर्स्ट वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज कोरिलेशन आईडी। A correlation ID is a unique identifier assigned to a request that allows tracking it through various components. We can print this correlation ID along with our logs that can be in a file or on the console. But why we need to use correlation ID in Spring Boot? Because there are some challenges. Sometimes it is difficult to trace the request in a distributed system without correlation ID. And the main benefit of using correlation ID is we can easily debug and troubleshoot with the help of correlation ID. For example, we have one API and this same API calling by multiple clients. So when the client will send HTTP request, so for each HTTP request, there will be one correlation ID will be generated automatically and it will be logged into our log file. And if there are multiple clients are sending the request, then we can uniquely identify each request with the help of correlation ID, because for each HTTP request, there will be one new correlation ID will be generated. And with the help of Spring Boot version 3.21, we no need to do more configuration to implement correlation ID. We just need to add one dependency and need to enable it. So that's enough. So okay, let's go through the code and see how logging behavior 3 before its version 3.2.1. So let me go, and here I have created one Spring Boot. So in this project I have created controller class, that is employee controller, and in this controller class I have added the logs. So here we can see get all employee name, get all employee. So I will execute this API, get all employee, and in this API I have just added logger info. So this is an employee controller get all employee method. When this method will execute, this log statement will be printed inside our log file or on console that we are using. So when I will open this method, so in this implementation class we can also check I have added logs, but I have not added any correlation ID in these logs. So here we can see these are the logs that I have added. So let me start this application and execute this rest endpoint, and we'll check the response. For now I have not enabled correlation ID in Spring Boot 3.2 version. So without correlation ID, first I will execute, after that I will add correlation ID. So let me run this application. So here I am using two clients, one will be the postman and second I will go through the browser. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Let me execute this rest endpoint get all employee. So let me go through browser and postman both. So first I will clear these all the logs from here. Now I will just execute rest endpoint from here. So let me copy this path and send the request, and same time I want to execute from here. So here I have executed the same endpoint get all employee and got all employee from here. So let me check the logs on console. So here we can see inside employee controller get employee method executed, and second employee service implementation get employee method, and third we can see get all employee is not empty, and these four logs printed with one HTTP request. And when I executed same rest endpoint again with second HTTP request, it was executed and printed these log statements. And we cannot identify which client and executed this request, because this is a small API and executed very fast. But if we will try to add here some code, like if I will add here some stoppage, so here I will use thread.sleep. For 2 seconds, and here I will just add catch block and we'll catch the exception. So just printing simple statement exception occurred. So let me stop my application and start it again. And after that, I will execute the same request from both the clients. So let me restart my application. Because this time this will execute it in the sequence, but now I will again execute the same rest endpoint. So it will sleep here once it will reach here, and in the meantime I will execute the second request. Easy. So I think 2 seconds is not enough, so I will increase it up to 5 seconds, and let me start application again. And now we can see here our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go back to our Postman and call this API, and same time I have to call from browser also. So two clients are executing the same request. So let me go to console and check the logs. So here we can identify this request with the help of thread. So here we can see first employee controller get employee method was executed, and which thread executed this? So thread number 2, and here we can see number 3, and after that 2 was executed here when get all employee is not empty, it was executed. And after that inside employee service implementation get all employee response, so first log statement printed here, so it was mixed. And it is not easy to identify because here we are not able to see any correlation ID or identity that we have added. With the help of threads we are able to identify, but we will again execute the same request, so same thread will again generate like 2 and 3 and 1, so it will again generate same thread name. So it is not easy to identify, so let me add correlation ID and we'll check the response again. So how we can enable correlation ID with Spring Boot 3.2 version. So first I will go inside our application.property file. So inside application.property file we just need to enable the tracing. So here I will just add management.tracing.enabled is equal to true. So only this property we need to add inside our property.file, application.properties file. We also need to check the Spring Boot version in our pom.xml. Here we can see it is 3.2.1, because version with 3.2.1 Spring Boot starts logging a correlation ID for all the logs relating to one HTTP request. For each HTTP request it will add one correlation ID. But we also need to enable micrometer tracing. So we have added in our application.properties, and we also need to add one dependency. So here I will just paste one micrometer dependency here. So I will go down. So in the end of dependencies, I will just add one dependency, that is micrometer tracing bridge brave dependency I have added. Now after adding this Maven dependency, once the client will send the request to our API, for each HTTP request it will add one correlation ID. So let me restart our application and check the log statement again. So stop it and run it again. So I have not done any configuration, I have just added one dependency, and in application.properties file I have enabled micrometer tracing. So here we can see now it's showing some empty spaces because we are not sending any HTTP client request, so it is showing empty. So once our application will start, we will execute the API and we'll check the response. So our application has started at port number 8080. So let me execute the rest endpoint. From here I am calling, and at that time I will call from here also. So let me check the logs now. So here we can see now within our logs we are able to see correlation ID. So with the help of correlation ID we can identify the client request. So this is the client one request, and after that the second request also, second log statement is also for client one, but the third statement is for another client, that is a different correlation ID. Here we can see So if I will scroll to this side, so here we can see inside employee controller. So here we can see first two log statements is for getting all employee method for client one and employee service implementation get employee method for client one, but this is for client two. Get all employee method that we can identify with the help of correlation ID. This is unique, and this is again same correlation ID that we can see here in the above two log statements. This is also same. So this is also for client one. So like this, with the help of correlation ID, we can identify the request. So this is the main benefit of using correlation ID. It will be easy to trace and debug the request. Okay, if you have not subscribed the Gain Java Knowledge channel, you might miss out on seeing us again. But if you are, then congratulations, you are a journey of continuous growth. Thanks for watching this video.